Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you. Thank you.
Hello students, welcome to Vastech channel. So today in this session, we will try to understand reliable data transfer protocol, that is Module 2 of Computer Networking Syllabus of 5th Semester CS and IS. So once again, welcome back. So in the my previous videos, I have covered 3.1, 3.2, 3.3. So before starting, let me mention once again, I am referring here the PPT from Computer Networking Top Down Approach Book 6th edition by James F. Kuroso, and this video is not for commercial purpose, this is only to help our students. So principles of reliable data transfer, when the name reliable data transfer means the data is sent from sender side to the receiver side without any loss. So normally data comes from the application layer to the transport layer, and always in our mind, transport layer will do the job of reliable data transfer. So please remember, in addition to this transport layer, reliable data transfer job is also a responsibility of a data link layer and some applications. So in the diagram, you can see the application layer, the data comes to the transport layer, and there are two processes. One is the sending process and other one is the receiving process, and data is sent through reliable channel. Data is sent through reliable channel. So here you can see, this is the sending process and the receiving process. The data comes from the upper layer to the transport layer, and transport layer will provide a passage, something called as reliable channel. This is the theoretical concept. Practically, it is very difficult to achieve. Or there are different methodologies to achieve reliability, because practically we are sending data through unreliable media. So on the receiving side, so in the diagram you can see, on the receiving side, here you can see, this is the service provided by the transport layer. This is the reality, because the data is sent through unreliable channel. So here the RDT send will receive the data. RDT send is the event. It will receive the data from the upper layer, and it will transfer that data through unreliable channel. On the receiving side, as soon as the data comes, RDT receive event will activate it, and it will transfer the data to deliver data event that will deliver the data to the upper layer. So UDT send, similarly you can see on the sender side, as soon as the data comes, so UDT send, it will send the data to the upper layer. So this is the simple service implementation of the reliable data transfer. So once again, you can see the same thing here. RDT send, as soon as the data comes, RDT send event is called, and data is passed to the RDT send. So RDT send will create the segment, and it will pass the data to the through the unreliable channel. On the receiver side, as the data comes, on the receiver side, as the data comes, RDT receive is called, and RDT receive will deliver the data to the deliver data event. So deliver data event is called to deliver the data to the upper layer. So reliable data transfer in the next slides or in the next session, you will see various types of reliable data transfer protocol. So we will start with the simple FSM, and we'll slowly develop or we'll see slowly what are the different types of reliable data transfer protocol. So we are using the word here RDT. RDT means reliable data transfer protocol, and we are using FSM, finite state machine, to represent the different state of transition. In the diagram you can see state 1 and state 2, and when the particular process moves from state 1 to state 2, what event causing the state transition and what action taken on the state transition. This is represented something like this next to this one state diagram. For example, here you can see this is the FSM representation, and this is the event, and this is the action taken when this event is executed. That means here in this FSM, it is waiting for the data from the upper layer. As soon as the data comes, RDT send event is activated, and RDT send event, what it will do, it will create the packet by using make underscore packet data, and UDT send will send the data from the sender side. On the receiver side, RDT receive event will be executed, and the actions are, it will extract the data from the packet and it will deliver that to deliver data event. So this is the representation of RDT 1.0. So now we will move to the RDT 2 channel with the bit error. So in practical, there will be, when you transfer data from one end to the other end, there will be a data loss or there will be a data corruption. So we will start with the simple assumption that there is a channel with the bit errors. That means some of the bits will be corrupted during the transmission from one end to the other end, and out to recover from this one. So to recover from this one, we are using two types of methodologies, something called as acknowledgements. Second one is a negative acknowledgement. That is something like acknowledgement. Something is something like receiver will tell sender that the packet is received, is okay. Negative acknowledgement is receiver will tell the sender that packet had errors and the sender need to transmit the packet once again. That is called as NAC. So there are two things. One is ACK. RDT2 works on ACK and NAC. ACK is nothing but positive acknowledgement. NAC is nothing but negative acknowledgement. This is something similar when I call the other person. So when I speak to him, he will acknowledgement by saying, say, okay, okay, okay. Suppose if there is any network problem and the other side, if he cannot hear properly, then he will say like, repeat, pardon. That is something called as negative acknowledgement. That indicates the sender that he has to repeat whatever he said. That is the meaning of NAC and ACK. So we will see now RDT2 FSM specification and how it works. In the last diagram, we have seen only one state. Here you can see there are two states. So we will see one by one in the next session. Thank you.